I Just Can't Stop Loving You, a 1987 duet with Quincy Jones' protege, Syeda Garrett, signaled a new era of music for Michael Jackson. The first lead single since the global juggernaut, Thriller, the unassuming ballad was also Michael Jackson's first single off his long-awaited follow-up record, Bad, and became the first in a string of 5 number one singles he achieved with this album. Although a Billboard number one, the unassuming ballad was considered an unusual release for an artist hoping to outdo himself with his upcoming record. This is the story behind the inspiration, production, and commercial reaction to one of pop history's most iconic music releases, Michael Jackson's 1987 hit, I Just Can't Stop Loving You. The inspiration. Certified 20 times platinum in 1984, Michael Jackson's Thriller and its huge commercial success built expectations for its follow-up. Jackson even set a goal to sell 100 million copies with his next album. The colossal sales expanded the limits of what was commercially possible and created a moment in which pop, and specifically Jackson, could sit at the center of a celebrity universe. The 4 years following Thriller were marred by Jackson's rifts with his family, broken friendships, business dealings, and the pressure of celebrity. In 1984, he seemed to be everywhere, on MTV and in Pepsi commercials, at the Grammys and the White House, on Rolling Stone and Time magazine, and all across the United States on the Victory Tour. The next year, however, besides a brief appearance in We Are the World, he was nowhere to be seen. In 1985, Jerry Hershey wrote for Rolling Stone, "It has been a black hole for Michael watchers who witnessed the most spectacular disappearing act. It was a strategic move from a performer who understood the power of anticipation and mystique." It was clear that Jackson was not merely a naive man-child or a song and dance man who knew and accepted his place as a static, submissive entertainer. He was outwitting some of the most powerful figures in the industry. He was growing artistically and financially, and he was beginning to learn how to wield his considerable power and cultural influence for more social and political ends. Reports spread of his changing physical appearance and eccentric behavior. In 1987, Spin wrote that, "In record time, Jackson has gone from being one of the most admired celebrities to one of the most absurd, and the pressure to restore himself in the public eye is paralyzing him." According to some associates, Jackson was nervous about completing his next album. "He's reminded that everyone is waiting for his record, and he goes into a shell. He's frightened." After Jackson had written a handful of the tracks on Off the Wall and Thriller, producer Quincy Jones encouraged him to write more for Bad. Jones recalled, "All the turmoil in Jackson's life was starting to mount up, so I said I thought it was time for him to do a very honest album. As a result, Jackson penned, I Just Can't Stop Loving You." When asked about the song's inspiration, Jackson replied, "I was thinking of somebody while I was singing it, but not while I was writing it." The production. The original album version of the song opened with Jackson cooing a spoken intro backed by a longer version of the opening music. According to Jackson, he recorded that part of his song while lying in bed, saying, "I was in a bed when I was doing that. I was laying under covers and everything." Producer Quincy Jones had the idea to insert this intro, giving an intimate and vulnerable look into Jackson's soul for an artist known for his public mystique and guardedness. Originally, Jackson envisioned I Just Can't Stop Loving You as a duet between him and Barbra Streisand, but Streisand turned him down because she believed, due to their age difference, it would make the lyrics unbelievable for audiences. She also said that she did not like the song and thought the single would not be successful. After Streisand's rejection, Jackson approached Whitney Houston to discuss whether she could be on the track. But Arista, her label, did not allow it as they feared Houston would be at risk of overexposure with such a high-profile collaboration. The presence of Syeda Garrett on the track was a last-minute decision by Michael Jackson and Quincy Jones. Garrett, a protege of Jones's, was constantly sent song demos, including one for I Just Can't Stop Loving You, although she didn't know that the demo was a song written and sung by Jackson. While reporting for a recording session, Garrett thought that she was summoned to do overdubs for the song she'd co-written for Bad, Man in the Mirror. Instead, she was surprised to learn that she'd been chosen to sing a duet with Jackson. I go into the booth. There's two music stands. Michael Jackson is standing at one of them in front of a microphone, and there's another microphone for me. This is the first time I realized what was happening. While recording, Jackson and Garrett didn't take the recording entirely seriously. Saida recalled, "If I was talking to Quincy and we were serious for some reason, Michael would toss cashews and peanuts at us. I would be talking to Quincy and these peanuts would fly by." You know, the duet is a very serious love song, and when I was doing my verse, Michael was making these faces at me so that I would mess up. Quincy would say, "Saida, come on, you're holding up the whole album," and I would get in trouble. The release. Without an accompanying music video, Thriller had been kicked off with something similarly low-key musically with The Girl Is Mine. But The Girl Is Mine had the clout of McCartney's involvement, an early sign of how ambitious Jackson was aiming to be. I Just Can't Stop Loving You reached number one on the Billboard Hot 100 the week of September 19, 1987. Despite the success, the duet had a relatively short chart run and fell out of the top 40 just 5 weeks after topping the chart. This was largely due to the quick release of the album title track as the second single. Jackson performed the song with background singer Sheryl Crow on his Bad Tour and reunited with Saida Garrett again on his Dangerous Tour. He also performed the song at the Royal Concert in Brunei in July 1996 with Marva Hicks. On Jackson's Bad Tour, Sheryl Crow mentioned it was set up to look like there was sexual chemistry between them, which led to untrue rumors and tabloid stories that they were an item. Crow explained in a 2008 interview that she got the job based on her all-American look. She felt Jackson's handlers wanted to pair him on stage with an innocent-looking girl so he would appear more normal. By this time, the press was increasingly speculating on Jackson's unorthodox behavior, and he was pressured by his management to display a more virile public image. Sheryl Crow once said, "He had something that was not definable to me. Whenever he stepped out and sang, whenever he made that connection with people, the molecules changed in the room."
If you are interested in understanding the man behind Michael Jackson, we are your dedicated channel. So hit subscribe as we tackle all things MJ with two new videos every week.